Hi everyone, I'm Johan. Today I'm going to talk to you about the Spotify software engineer interview process. At the end of this video, you should have a good understanding of the process itself, what interviewers look at, and a bunch of tips for each round. Before concluding, I'll talk briefly about a specific, unique interview round that Spotify throws into the mix for a software engineering candidate. Quick intro, I'm from Prepfully. This interview has been put together by Spotify software engineers who are also interview coaches on Prepfully, the very same ones who have helped hundreds of candidates with mock interviews and advice. This is a video version of our much more in-depth written guide, which we'll link within the description. And you can always book time with the coaches directly for more personalized guidance on Prepfully's website. Okay then, moving on to the interview. So, the Spotify software engineer interview process spans 2 to 6 months and consists of 4 main rounds. Firstly, an online assessment. Second, a video / telephone interview. And third, a tech-based screen. Finally, the on-site round, which consists of 4 interviews. Let's first get the online assessment out of the way. This one essentially is an at-home online screening test that is used to confirm your eligibility for the position. It evaluates your IQ, language, and math skills, so spend some time reviewing basic math and language concepts and you should be good. Now to the actual interview process. It starts with the video / telephone interview, which is a one-on-one chat with one of Spotify's recruiters. The conversation revolves around your background, your past experiences, your technical skills, and the role you are applying for. Here are my 4 tips for this round. Tip 1, make sure you have a short and crisp introduction ready to go when the recruiter asks, "So tell me about yourself." Maybe also include a nugget about yourself that makes you stand out. Second, this round mostly focuses on your soft skills, so make sure you practice your communication skills well. Third, gather your thoughts about your previous work experiences and decide ahead which specific projects you will discuss. Focus on topics like what your contribution was, how things went, and what you could have done better. Third, have a clear reason for why you're applying at Spotify, as well as why you think you'd succeed. Right then, next is the hour-long technical-based screening. It typically includes questions about your previous experiences, some technical domain questions, and 2 or 3 LeetCode-like, usually easy, coding problems. 2 quick tips for this round. Make sure you fully understand the problem before you write code. It's important to collaborate with the interviewer and be open to their suggestions if you're going down the wrong path. As with the recruiter call, be prepared to talk about past projects, your role in them, and decide in advance which ones you'd want to leverage for different stories, such as something you were particularly proud of versus something you learned from. If you pass the technical phone screen, you'll be invited to an on-site interview. This round typically consists of 4 interviews. 1 programming / DSA round, 1 system design round, 1 values behavioral round, and finally, the unique interview that we talked about earlier. There is also a team matching session and an offer and negotiation stage. Let's discuss each interview, starting with the programming DSA round. During this stage, you can typically expect domain-based and programming questions revolving around your current tech stack and topics like OOP concepts, data structures like strings, arrays, UDP / TCP protocols, and so on. 3 tips for this round. The coding problems are typically the ones you find on LeetCode, but they can be really difficult as well. So make sure you carefully read and understand the prompt before diving into a solution. Make sure to ask clarifying questions if you're unsure about any aspect of the prompt. Next, it's important to clearly communicate your thought process as you work through the problem. Review your knowledge of algorithms, including sorting algorithms, parsing, recursion, data structures, and so on. Moving on to the next round, the system design interview. Here, you are evaluated on your ability to design and implement a high-level system. The interviewer may ask you to design a system for a specific use case or to solve a particular problem. This interview covers a tremendous amount of ground and is one of the harder ones to get through. So here's 4 tips for this round. Keep in mind, the focus of this interview will be in your problem-solving process and approach rather than quick solutions. Make sure you demonstrate an understanding of the core components of a system, how they work together. Communicate your thought processes. Explain your design choices at every stage. Next, collaborate with your interviewers and ask clarifying questions whenever needed. Lastly, I'd recommend practicing with a mock interviewer. There are several Spotify software engineers who provide great practice and guidance on dealing with the twists and turns this interview can take. And you can book a slot with them on Prepfully. Links in the description below. This brings us to the final round, the behavioral interview. Spotify is trying to gauge how you'd respond to the company's work culture and how you'd address challenging scenarios. They may ask an open-ended question to prompt you to share examples from your past experiences. Make sure you think ahead and review your past experiences and identify specific examples that demonstrate your abilities in areas such as leadership, problem solving, and communication. Practice answering behavioral questions under simulated interview conditions so you can deliver concise, effective responses. Candidates have reportedly been rejected for a lack of self-confidence and inadequate communication skills. Another tip is to research Spotify's culture and values. Try aligning your responses with them. Right then, the promised discussion on the Spotify-specific unique round. This is actually a case study round where the interviewer simulates an on-call issue response scenario and prompts the candidate to solve a real-world problem. The prompt would go something like, Spotify has just released a new feature and users are reporting performance issues. How would you go about investigating and resolving the problem? You will then have to analyze the problem and propose potential solutions. The interviewer may ask follow-up questions to further evaluate your approach. This is basically a test of your problem-solving skills in a complex, time-sensitive situation. So, in this context, it's not just important to demonstrate your problem-solving skills, but also that you leverage a structured approach to work under pressure and challenging circumstances. That's all from me. Don't forget to check out our more in-depth written guide in the video description and book a slot with Prepfully's software engineer coaches for personalized guidance. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully. And we hope you totally rock your interview.